In this video, we'll show you how to build an automation that sends a welcome email to contacts when they submit a form, then adds tags to those contacts based on if they clicked a link in an email, if they opened the email, or if they took no action. Automation triggers and actions are literal. They will only do what you tell them to. Also, if you're using a double opt-in for your form, it's important to note that contacts will only be added to this automation when they complete the double opt-in process. Without further ado, let's get started. First, click Automations. Then, click New Automation. The recipe modal will pop up. Since we're creating our own custom automation, we're going to select the Start from Scratch option and click Continue. The trigger modal will open. Since we want to pull contacts into this automation when they submit a form, we're going to select the Submits a Form trigger. Next, we're going to select the form we just created in an earlier video in the dropdown. To prevent the same contacts from restarting this automation if they submit this form again, we're going to configure this trigger action to run once. Now, we're going to click Add Start. The Add New Action modal will load automatically. Since we want to send a welcome email using the template we created earlier, we're going to click Send Email. Next, we're going to click Create an Email, then provide an internal name for this email in the next box. The template library will load. We're going to select the template we already created. The Sender Details box will open. Here you can edit your from name, an email address, and also provide a subject line. These items can always be changed later. The email builder will load and you can make further edits to your email. I'm going to add a link to this call to action box. Once everything looks ready to go, click Next so you can review the campaign summary page. Once everything looks complete, click Finish at the top of the page. Now, we're going to add a wait action under the Send Email step before we add a series of if-else statements that checks to see how contacts interacted with this email. The reason why we're adding this wait action is because contacts will need time to receive the email and see it in their inbox so that they can hopefully open it and click the link that we provided. To add that wait step, click the node under the email, and the action modal will reopen. Click Conditions and Workflow, and then click Wait. Now you get to decide if contacts should wait for a specific period of time, or if they should wait until a specific condition is met. If you choose Wait until a specific condition is met, you can set a time limit so contacts aren't stuck in this step indefinitely. For this walkthrough, it makes the most sense for us to use the Wait Until option because contacts will be able to move to the next step in the automation as soon as they meet the conditions we set. After choosing the Wait Until option, the Conditions Editor will open. Here you'll get to specify the conditions that the contacts must match. Continuing with our example, we're going to have contacts wait in this step until they click a link in our welcome email. To do that, we're going to click the Conditions dropdown and select Actions. Now we're going to select Has clicked on a link. Next, we're going to choose the campaign, which is the welcome email, and the link provided. Once the condition is set, click Save. Now we'll want to set a time limit. You can think of this as specifying how long contacts should wait in this step if they have not clicked the specified link. While you can set any time limit that makes the most sense for your business, we're going to set it to 7 days. If contacts have not interacted with this campaign within that time frame, then they are most likely never going to. Once the time limit is configured, click Save. Okay. So now our contacts have enough time to interact with the welcome email once it's sent to them. Now we're going to split them up based on how they interacted with this email and apply tags to them. To do that, we're going to add the first of two if-else statements. An if-else statement will create a fork in your automation with two paths. The yes path will be for contacts who meet the conditions you defined, and the no path is for contacts who did not meet those conditions. To add this step, click the node under the wait and click if-else. The conditions editor will open. We're going to set the condition in the first if-else statement to look for contacts who clicked the link in our welcome email. As you can see, the if-else statement has created a fork with two paths we mentioned earlier. Contacts who click the link within 7 days will go down this yes path, and contacts who don't will go down the no path. Now let's add a tag step to our yes path so we can tag contacts who clicked our link. To do that, we're going to click the node, then contacts, then add tag. The tag we're going to add to these contacts will be clicked CTA link in welcome email. Now we'll want to add a tag to contacts who only opened the email. To do that, we're going to add another if-else statement under the no path. In the conditions editor, we're going to use has opened welcome email. So you want to go to Actions, Has Opened, Welcome Email, and click OK. Just like before, we're going to add a tag step to the Yes path and tag contacts with Opened Welcome Email. Under the No path, we're going to add a tag Did Not Engage with the Welcome Email. Now there are a few things we need to do before contacts can enter this automation. The first is to give your automation a short yet descriptive name. We're going to call this Welcome Series. The other very important detail to remember is to turn the automation on when you're ready. To do that, click Active. Now we have an automation that will send a welcome email to contacts who submit our form. Once they're sent an email, they'll wait up to 7 days before moving through the first if-else statement that checks to see if they clicked a link. If they did, they're tagged and they end the automation. If they did not, they'll move to the second if-else statement that checks to see if they opened the email. If they did, they'll get tagged based on that action and will end the automation. And if they did not, they'll be given a different tag and will end the automation. As contacts are added to the automation, you'll be able to see the number of contacts that are moving through the automation and how well the email is performing right from the automation's overview page.